All right, welcome back to Skyward Sword HD, the hero mode playthrough. I've now got all the items, everything's been upgraded. I have achieved my dreams in the boss rush. So now we head to the finale. Oh wait, it's over the other side. But yeah, if you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for tuning in, and just know that this is part of a longer stream. So this is effectively your part two. You can't imagine playing the older Zelda games without access to a guide and not throwing the console out the window. But I guess for me, it's just because we had very few games, so I just... Maybe I was just a stubborn little kid, but I just... Okay, this is probably the last time I'm gonna see this, so fine. But I just kept playing the game until I got it. And since we didn't have many games... I think in the context of today where I'm a bit spoilt for choice, probably would give up if I was to be experiencing stuff for the first time. But back then, getting a new game was just a luxury and a half. Whenever you got stuck on the game, you just switched back to Ocarina of Time because you could finish it. The game that I played through over and over again was Mega Man 2. Because I was good at that. And Mario Brothers 1, because I was really good at that. Mario Brothers 3 was like a school holiday thing. Alright, now that we've gotten the obligatory cat section out of the way. Here we go. March to the end. Also had few games. If you didn't switch to Ocarina of Time, you'd just start a new save file and hope that replaying it would help. It would not. That's what I did with Zelda. The first Zelda, I would get to the point where I was looking for Castle 7. I wouldn't find Castle 7, and then I would start again at some point and try again, and it just never helped. And then as a teenager, I found Castle 7 by mistake and finished the game 10 years later as a teenager, so... Master, I have information to report. I've detected three sources of sacred power within this building. This power clearly radiates from the Triforce. I've triangulated the three sources of power and marked them on your map as the triangle. Oh yeah, this is like... the room designer. Hated this part. It is a little bit annoying. It does take a while to do. Especially because it's not as straightforward as just going directly to the paths. Now the buildings you can see, yeah. Okay. You can see there's keys involved. So it's not as simple as just going straight there. I think this concept is cool. It's just... gets a little tiresome. No knock on the actual dungeon, just not good at it. Yeah. Have you tried hero mode yourself, Confirmy? Honestly, I thought this was gonna be worse than what it was, but this has gone well. Hell no. Didn't you just say you like to be good at things? This is the ultimate get good for this game. Stamina loss would be frustrating. It's not as bad as you think. Oh, it doesn't cut it? It's not as bad as you would think. I'm surprised the arrow didn't cut it. If I was to put it in percentage, it's like maybe 15% stamina loss, if not 10. It's just, you have to make it count, that's all, in certain areas. But it's not enough to slow you down a lot. Just wait until I get up to Breath of the Wild, oh boy. Base stamina and 3 hearts! 90% of the playthrough. You couldn't do Ocarina of Time Master Mode because you don't like that change. I haven't tried that one yet. The Master Quest thing. I think this was alright. I have to get all this. Is that it? There's surely more. I'll have a scout. We're fine. Now we can go. Hello, caller, and welcome. How's it going? Maybe you'll do hero mode for Tears of the Kingdom. That's if they put it in to begin with. You know how Nintendo are with their announcing a DLC immediately after the game releases? That's their go-to move now. Get the season pass. Have I been in the game already? Yeah, this is my second playthrough of it. I'm doing hero mode. But I played when it first released on the Switch, so... It's just I'm playing through all the Zelda games before Tears of the Kingdom comes out, so... I am up to this one at the moment. Wasn't Master Quest a new cartridge? I don't know. It came on a CD for the GameCube with Wind Waker. I don't know what they did with it. I have that discs. I've never used it. Oof. Okay. Thank you for the follow, Messiah. Appreciate it. Welcome. Damn it. It's okay. I'm surprised this doesn't damage you. I think things would have gone much worse for me if this damaged you every time you fell. Oh, that was probably way too high up. Wait, what did I do here? I messed up. What did I do? Shouldn't have gone here. The worst is when you want Link to jump, but he just walks off the edge and hangs off it. Yeah. Someone's gonna wonder how I got this shield. That's a little embarrassing. This dude has the Hylian shield and he's running off edges. What is this? I don't know. With Tears, I'm just hoping they show what we're gonna be doing this time around. Because they've been kind of quiet about it. They've shown gameplay mechanics, which they look cool. But there's no real... I kind of worry that this is going to feel like a DLC as opposed to like a full-fledged sequel. Oh, come on. I would like to finish this tonight so we can move on to Link Between Worlds. I am really looking forward to Link Between Worlds. Jeez. I don't know why I'm doing it in reverse. I think I'm overcomplicating it for myself. Not impressed by what you see. Yeah, I think Tears of the Kingdom is, from what I've seen so far, it's gonna be fun. But I don't think it's gonna be nearly as revolutionary or as, like, big feel that Breath of the Wild had. Just because it's using the same world again, so... It's kind of one of those things that I wish I could experience again for the first time. What do I even want here? I guess... Oh, yeah. That's an arrow. Cool. I needed ammo. That goes back there. What time is it where I am? It is 9 PM on a Thursday. I am on the east coast of Australia. How about yourself? Where are you tuning in from? 7 AM, jeez. Confirming, pulling the all-nighter again. Look that way. The design carved into the floor is the mark of furor. I detect sacred power of the Triforce emanating from its vicinity. To reach the area where the mark is located, I propose you pass through the door in front of you. Night owl hours? Yeah, well, I mean, if you're tuning in from the start, yes, night owl hours. If you're just tuning in now, that's the early bird. Just about 7 AM in New York, man. I don't know. I used to have to get up that early, if not earlier, to get to work at 9. Don't have... Too much time has passed. I need to get the treasure chest, so the bottom left tile needs to come with me. But at least... This part is done. I have the gate open, so... The nice thing about being a call is there's no bedtime since you never know when a call will come in. Yeah, I mean, it suits people. I kind of personally wish that the concept of polyphasic sleep was more attainable, but that requires having a job that's flexible enough that'll let you sleep very often. But the idea is you take multiple naps during the day and effectively you're awake for more of a... the day, so you get more time. Ooh. Wait, how am I gonna get that out? What? No, I have to do it another way. You're lurking using me to keep you busy while you work. Nah, all good. I can appreciate that. I do the same when I'm at work. What do you do if you don't mind me asking? Why am I trying to get this out of the corner? Okay, let me look at the pieces. I'm gonna see what else I can do here. I have zero recollection of this dungeon, so... This is something I can go through. Medical building? Ah, okay. Alright. Yeah, I mean, typically I get people that want to watch something late at night and want to chill. or people that are going about their day and need something in the background. I mean, they have a radio voice apparently, so. Hey Laura. Yeah, I got everything now, so. This is the end of the game. Oh, right. Nope. Okay, this is how I'm gonna play this. A face or radio? Wouldn't you like to know? Uh-oh. Nope, no stunt, no touchy. All right. I'm ready. Damn it. I was ready. How many games left? 3. Uh-oh. Link Between Worlds, Triforce Heroes, Breath of the Wild. Nearly up to the big one. I'm trying to get through these last ones, so then I give myself roughly a month of Breath of the Wild. I think I'm gonna make it. When's the new one? 2nd week of May. Through 3 hours of torture to get this shield. But I'm so glad I did, even if it's inconsequential in the final fight. I don't care, this is style points. This is the way it should be. Can't throw it. This feels like Portal, even though Portal's... No, this is a good puzzle. The dungeon where this mechanic was done, it was pretty good. Oh, I can't roll it. Can I throw it? I can't throw it through the door. About, it's too heavy, so I can't throw it high. Okay, what am I missing here? I just want to make sure there's no rude interruptions. Yeah. How am I gonna ferry this across? Hang on. It's not targetable. Can't make it go upwards. Okay. I just thought maybe that was what I needed to do. Complicated it. This is the way. Too far. Come back. Come back. Come back. Uh-oh. Come back. Is there a button I can press to retract it? Uh-oh. Do I have to I have to leave the room, don't I? I have to leave the room. No. Wait, no, 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 no. Okay, there's a contingency. That's the thing. Okay, it's fine. I messed up. Just needed to see. Game, please. Slowly. All right, good enough. Reverse it, right? Yeah, okay. I see. Okay. But I don't remember if I need to do this in a specific order or not. Let me watch it a sec. Okay. doesn't look like there's a perceived order. So maybe I just have to do it with a timer or something. Okay, I'll wait for it to be at the very end. And go. There we go. I hope this is right. I guess we're here. No, we're here. We're in this corner. Wait a minute, what? No, I'm here. We are here. Okay. Seeing a button and wonder about its purpose. What button? I'm worried. You ever seen that Family Guy bit where Peter walks into a room and there's a button on the wall that says don't press? And then he presses the button and someone kicks him in the stomach? I think I got this. It's just... I think I should move the piece that I don't think I'm going to interact with right away into the corner. So this one. Okay. Push it if you want. You can press it if you want. It's fine. I thought for a sec it was like gonna be the warrior button, but thank you so much for using that prime sub. Appreciate it a lot. Wait a minute. Oh no. No, wait, it's fine. Thought I needed to go back that way. Especially for, tuning in and hanging out for a bit. Do appreciate that. Also, probably the first person I've seen in a while to just straight up call me Will. Which I do like. My stream name chat, I came up with it because I wanted something that wasn't used across all the social media platforms. I've never really used it for anything else. It is nonsensical to some degree. Alright. 33 months of chicken. Oh, Lello, it didn't pop up yet. Hey, man. How's things? Really? 33 months? Man. We really did spend 2 years. In a state of just losing time. How's things, man? It's been a while. How's the job going? Ah, crap. Yeah, well, how am I? Doing good. I've taken a week off for Easter, so just powering through these Zelda games before Tears comes out. Damn it. I didn't parry. Didn't parry again. Show them why I earned the shield. Right, it's three phases, isn't it? Ah, double stab. Ah! Come on, don't push me into the fence. Oh no. I might have to use my best potion. Oh, I gotta remember the double stab. I don't want to lose. Committed. Okay, nope. Okay, parry is allowed. First try. Correct. Yeah, I've been doing a lot of sword fighting. Not just that, I've upgraded the firmware on my controllers because they were acting jank. And now I'm playing somewhat properly. I'll always use the word somewhat. Okay. Right? Wait, why is that not allowed? What the? That's okay. What am I playing this on? This is on the Switch, so it's the HD version. But every other game that I've played, so I've played through all of them except one. I've been using the original hardware where possible. It's just some of these the definitive edition, so it's better to play the HD version. So for Ocarina and Majora's, I played it on the 3DS. For Wind Waker and Twilight Princess, I played the Wii U versions. I am using motion controls this time, because the first time I played it with analog sticks. Wait, where is this leading to? Oh. You want to play now? You should. I mean, if you own it or you want to get it. Especially in the lead up to Tears, there's elements of this that are in the trailer. Particularly falling down onto an island in a sky island. It just has that vibe. So yeah, I went completely the wrong way. You have a Switch, you'd have to get the game. If you've never played it before, I think it's worth it. I was on that boat, I hadn't played it before. But I mean, it is a nice looking game. It's the only Switch game I've seen that runs at 60 FPS. Like, I don't know how they did this. Played on the Wii since it came out, but it's been a long time since then. I mean, they do have enhancements, so... Okay. This is a problem. Is it bad that I say that I don't remember how to deal with these? Alright. Let's go for Galaxy Brain strategies. Don't panic. Confuse your enemies! Oh shit. I went too far. But, you know what? Since I don't take damage, get in there! Hey, that's how you win a fight. Dude had to get me on the way down. Good. Where's that arrow coming from? Up that. Hold on. Okay. Uh-oh. Corner. Corner. Put it away, put it away. Motion controls are better in this game for sword fighting. They really are, because flicking the analog sticks, it didn't work as well. Especially for parts where you have to be really quick. Wait, why is the battle music still going? Chat? I think my glitch passive just went off, potentially. Bug? Really? Are you sure there's nothing I have to do to end this sequence, maybe? No, it's not. You gotta continue here. It's fine, it's not a bug. It continues here. On that note... It seemed like I broke it, but I assume this is where you go. Alright, here we go. That being said, I have had jank things happen in this game, so it's fine. My best to just ignore the surrounding things, but it's hard. I might have to. Okay, I think I can focus now. Love how you eat, what, the bobos? The goblins? Okay, good. I think that was the best call, is just not focus on them, but... anyway, sorry. I did not read chat for a while, but Metroid Prime is a good remaster as well, so you should get it. So, I am not hired by Nintendo. If anything, I say bad things about them all the time, but I can appreciate when they make good games, and they make some of my favorite games. Did I play the Diablo 4 beta? I did. I actually got to play it during the private beta as well. So, like, the invite-only one last year. It's good. Just concerned about whether or not they're going to be done on time. I think... As far as a game that you're going to play from a story perspective, it's going to be fun. And I think the MMO aspects have been done in a manner that are pretty seamless. And this comes from someone that doesn't play MMOs and doesn't like them, so... If you have people to play with, I think it's going to be great. But otherwise, there's a few question marks, because there's effectively no solo self found in this game. So, yeah. We'll see. Okay. You prepare for an out of season's April Fool joke, but you keep hearing good things about it. I mean, it's gonna have a battle pass, it's gonna have cosmetics, but... It's kind of in the same vein of Overwatch. It's just you can ignore the cosmetics completely. It doesn't have any of that grotesque stuff that Diablo Immortal had. I think you'll enjoy it. Have I seen the overlay they did for this game on the Wii? The Wiimote down the side, I have, yeah. It looks... But, you know, it kind of fits. Because... Look at Fee. By the way, if this is one thing you'll be glad to hear, is that Fee has been turned down in this version of the game. She doesn't interject as much. Still interjects, but just not to the extent she did in the original. I haven't experienced the original, but it was one of the selling points of this game was Fee has been modified to the point where she's not as annoying. Okay, so let me see. We're here. I guess let's just see what's required for this room, because I doubt you can go in there right away. Free Fee. Are you gonna be sad when this game ends and you never see Fee again? I still think Navi is worse, but I think in this case I would have rather have dealt with Navi. Navi is, it's more of a, it's not that the advice is annoying, it's that the sound is annoying. Fee just states what's already happened and just pops up like a bad office assistant from the 1990s, like a paperclip. If you can find a way through the river of magma, I calculate a 60% chance. Stuff like this. Like, uses hedging language. Never says 100% chance. Imagine someone taking this seriously, like, oh, 60%, damn. Maybe I should go somewhere else, because it seems like this isn't the right way to go. I don't know what possessed them to do that. I still like this game, though. I say that like she's not going to be in Tears of the Kingdom. One thing I did point out was, the way Girahim looks, what's going on with his arms, it's pretty reminiscent of what happens to Link's arms in Tears of the Kingdom. I mean, the, kind of tribal patterns, they look very similar, which... is interesting. And there's also the whole thing where, I mean, the mummified thing they find, which we're assuming is Ganondorf, has the stab wound in the same spot that, Ganondorf from Twilight Princess has it. So... it'll be interesting to see where this game lies. Outside of just, okay, yeah, it's meant to be Breath of the Wild sequel. A ton of this game's assets are in Breath of the Wild. That's just game development, though. The reusing of assets, it's pretty common. There's no need to reinvent the wheel. Why am I using this? Really? Not a single one of them hit? There we go. I was just trying to save arrows, but... right. You want to see a wild thread I don't know if it's still on Twitter, but there's a thread of game developers talking about the biggest shortcuts they took when it came to making a game. Whether it be like just a janky way of making something or just reusing a particular asset. I forget which game it is, but one of them uses a standard tank and then they use the tank to make a boss. Skyrim, instead of having tables, they just reused bookshelves. There's a bunch of stuff like that. It's concerning because I did charge them, but it's already asking to charge them again. They should survive another hour, hopefully. You know what? My plan B should be I should get my other Joy-Cons and put them here. Hold up. That would have been the smart thing to do. Because I have two sets of them. Let me do that now, chat, so we don't have any downtime. Give me 30 seconds! I just had to go get him from the other room. Okay, they're in the dock. Don't forget to update the firmware. I think these ones should be updated. Okay, but yeah, by the time these ones run out, the other ones will be ready. They won't be. Well, they should. These ones already should have a bit of charge on them. Even if I have to swap them out like every hour, it's fine. It just takes a minute. I'll change them whenever. Uh-oh. What have I done? Why isn't this move? Oh, crap. Something else. I have to manually update. No, but I guess what I'm saying is I've manually updated them before. We'll see. If it feels bad, I'll do it, but... It's just because these ones are new. Hurry up! No, wait, it didn't work! I'm gonna run out of arrows. Okay, in the interest of saving arrows... But this is not going to move now, right? No, it does. Okay. It's because everything looks the same. I've been watching a lot of One Piece and there's a character in there that just gets disoriented and lost so easily. I often feel like him. Where is that coming from? I hear the battle music. Uh-oh. I messed up. It's fine. Ah, I forgot to... I forgot to hit the switch! Dear. So what happens if you just run out of ammo? Are you just screwed? Oh dear. Anyway, on the topic of Diablo 4, if Lelo, if you're still around, then you are gonna play it. I'd be down to play as well. I mean, I know a few people from the stream that are getting it as well. If you need further convincing. But that being said, the game is... it's just another one of these ones that has a marked up retail price, because that's just how things are now. I can use bug. That is true, but this is less downtime. I suppose I could use it now. And this has been upgraded to... where is it? No, that's just Rippy. What? Where is it? Oh, it's just this one. I just hit it again, right? No? Hang on. What am I looking at? Where is it? I mean, it doesn't matter. I can just stand on that as long as I need to. There's no rush to get off this one, so let's just do what we need to do. Alright, where is this? I am safe as long as I am here. Well, if that one's anything to go by, it should just be directly above this thing, but it's not. This. I probably passed it twice. Someone's internally screaming right now. I'm sorry if you're internally screaming. Hate this. This is one of these things, the longer something takes, the more likely the answer is something obvious and stupid. And yep, the answer was obvious and stupid. So. I guess if claw shot works, then... Ooh. Okay. I have to use arrows here. Wait, what is it? Oh, right. Listen. Do you see that shield on my back? That is the badge of honor I have earned for being a good player of this game. Now sure, I might get lost from time to time, but this is hero mode and I've earned that. Master, I have deduced that you have just acquired. Just waiting for it. No, we've got Lazalfos. Oh, there it is. Thank you for the follow, Dan Dan. Welcome. Appreciate it. Oh, right. Good morning. Good morning to you. I'm guessing you're on the side of the world where it's your day is just starting. If I'm any better at beating those things. Yeah, I know. Hang in there. I want to buy as much time for these other Joy-Cons. It's yelling at me, I know. But usually, you get the notification 3 times and then they give out, so. I mean, let me just. Yeah, that's. I mean, I wouldn't say that they're charged, so. I'm so organized. They're gonna dodge. Yeah. Alright. That is the first time I fought one of those things and it has not hit me. Not a single hit. Oh no. Let's go. With motion controls as well. I thought that was gonna take a while, but hey. Every now and then I'll do something somewhat impressive. Canadian just woke up and your raid has led you here. Raid? Oh right. Yeah, Iona. makes sense. I completely lost track of the fact that there was a raid earlier. Well, good morning and appreciate you for checking out the stream. Battery, hang in there. Just 5 more minutes. Come on, I can do this. What if I... Oh, nope. Yep, nope. Like... For some reason... I can do this pretty easily. It's just from the other side. I don't know why. It just starts doing that. Hold on. Center. I'm a lefty chat, so like, swinging my right hand like this is... Alright, do you know what? That's good enough. It doesn't have to be all of them. I'm being pedantic here. I vaguely remember this. What? Something on here. Seek the gemstones that sleep behind each statue. If you strike them in order from lowest to highest, the door will open. Right. But it's something that's timed, I believe. Lowest to highest. Okay. So we have to hit that one first. No, no, oh, no! I was trying to stand in the spot where I could reach them all by bow. Hang on. I don't think it's doable, but I think I can hit these two at least with a bow, and then the last one. Okay, so reset. Okay. Wait, what did that? Don't think it's timed? All right. Lowest to highest. That the sound of it sounds like a train. Okay. Ooh. Guess I need to be quick, huh? All I need is the pan flute. I thought you were gonna say it was all I need is the hairdryer. So I can actually do the puzzles. Chat, for those of you that don't know what I'm referring to there, before this I played Spirit Tracks, and for 90% of that game, I was holding a stylus in my left hand and a hairdryer in the right hand, because a lot of the sections that involved blowing into the microphone did not really work on the 3DS that well. Especially the last puzzle. I spent 25 minutes blowing a hairdryer into my 3DS, trying to do the last song. Motion controls just seem like such a luxury now. Right when I was about to give up, I got it. Very creative. I had to do it because I feel like my cheeks would have started hurting after a while. Wait, did I just go back through where I... Yeah. Hang on, where am I going? Sometimes you have to do stuff like that. Oh. Work smarter, not harder. Exactly. Though in this case, working harder is just giving yourself physical and mental pain. The 3DS has a decent mic, it's just for some reason on the DSM emulation it doesn't work, I know. Because that is emulation. It would have to be if the mic isn't working. How's Sky keep going? It's going well, Cookie. It's going well. As you can see, Link is at his final form. I think this is one of the sections where you feel the lack of stamina the most. I'd love to see me play Samus Returns. It'll happen. It's gonna happen. I have a copy of it behind me. I do intend to play it. It's just, probably won't happen until... Not when Tears of the Kingdom is done, more just I'm done with the Zelda stuff, and then Tears of the Kingdom I'll kind of take at my own pace. Like, I'm in no rush to get that finished. You will see Samus Returns. And probably Zero Mission and Fusion. Because I do want to replay those. It's more that I'm trying to do it wrong. Trying to do what wrong? Chase the thing? Thank you for the follow as well, Colrin. Appreciate it. Prime 4 comes out, I should do the series as a build-up. That is very tempting. Assuming they haven't released, well, I'm assuming they're gonna do the same treatment as far as, remastering goes, but you never know. I did read somewhere that, there's a rumor going around that it's not gonna be the same level of remaster that Prime 1 was, and instead it's gonna be just a lesser one. Like, it's still gonna be remastered, but not the same visual treatment, which I hope that's not the case, but it might be. I'll be a little sad if that's the case, because the remaster for Prime was excellent. Okay, hang on. Am I gonna stream Tears of the Kingdom when it comes out too? That's the idea. Since last year, I've been going through every single Zelda game and playing it in the lead up to this. There's one that I couldn't play just because owning an original copy of that is not realistic. Just because it's super expensive and you need a Game Boy Advance as well to play it. But other than that, I've played every single one. Not talking about the remasters. Going for the OG ones, like going GameCube and Wii. Bottom left is the one that I need to move. Have I just... Oh no, I see. I need to go back now. I see, I need to get it out of that corner. Okay, hold up. I need a path back. I hope that's correct. Once Prime 4 is announced. Yeah, we'll see. What time do I normally start streaming? Whatever the time is for you now, minus 4 hours typically. But on weekends, it's different. I have been trying to do hours that are a bit more friendlier to Americans. But typically, it is the night owl stuff. It's just, unfortunately, that's the reality of Australian streamers is you have two options. You either stay up late or you get up at the crack of dawn. And I'm not a morning person. But since the daylight savings has ended, it does mean that you'll be likely to catch me in the morning your time. Because it's only 10 p.m. here, and I usually go for like a couple more hours, if not more. But because I don't have work this week, I am pulling late night shifts here. If this does go beyond the hobby, I will look at like getting up early, but I think for now there's no need to do it. I mean, if you can't catch a stream, I do keep my VODs on Twitch, but also I do upload them to YouTube so people can catch up. Because I struggle to get heart pieces, sometimes I need strong to stay up longer. Just had to throw that jab in there. Well, does this game count? Wow, okay. I did not do that, chat, but the bot, yes. Good timing, bot. Am I on TikTok too? Yeah, I do put clips up there from time to time. I need to get more on top of it. I've been focusing more on YouTube shorts lately, but I need to get around to uploading them to TikTok as well. I'm on TikTok. Well, you kind of have to be a streamer. I don't... Kira, if it helps, I don't browse TikTok. Does that make it better? Yes, yeah, I don't browse TikTok. It's just... I've said this before, this isn't because, you know, old man yells at the sky, that's not it at all. It's just, I've never been that way. Even back in the days where, like, MySpace and Facebook were a thing, I never did any of that stuff. So, I've always been pretty consistent when it comes to social media. It's like, I'll be on there because the kind of work I do requires me to be on there. But for personal stuff, it's just... I'll connect with people and catch up with friends, but beyond that, I don't really browse it. I had the puzzle solved. Oh, you popped the YouTube command. Okay. I didn't see it. What do you mean I had the I had the puzzle solved? When? What? And I undid it. Ah, I see. I see. Yeah, but I guess I focus too much on talking sometimes. It's sacrifice I'm willing to make for you, the viewer. Okay, but I just need this piece to the left now. This is gonna take me 3 times as long now because, of course it will. What? Did I do it again? No, it's done. It's done. It's done. Don't worry. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. Chat, it's done. It's okay. It just shows that I'm human. Be fine with me continuing for that long. I wouldn't be. There was a lot of internal screaming. I do what I can. Wait, this goes out. Oh wait, no, it doesn't. Right, because it's changed. Never mind. Am I gonna play Pushmo again? Yeah, I will. It's just this last week, I've been really just wanting to make sure that this gets done in a good time so that we dedicate enough time to Breath of the Wild, that's all. But I will go back to playing more than one game, probably starting again next week, so. Pushmo was fun. Okay. So this is the wisdom trial. You have to be galaxy brain here. Jeez. It's okay. It's not the worst thing I've gotten stuck on. Sometimes you have moments where you're just incapable of doing something, and that's okay. As long as you can laugh about it later. Whoops. Let's just get rid of all the threats first. One day someone's gonna make a compilation of me getting stuck on stuff. That would be a very long compilation. It would be, because I've been streaming for a while. I know you meant it in another way, but I'm gonna take it this way. 5 hours of Spirit Tracks pan flute. I wish the microphone didn't cut out the sound of the hairdryer. It makes me happy about my microphone that it's really that good. But it would have been funnier if you could hear the whirring of the hairdryer when I was doing all that Spirit Tracks stuff. Would have been better. But it's fine. Okay, so this is... I don't remember the puzzle completely, but... I'm just looking around, seeing what's available. Mostly because I've been streaming for a while, that there are some times where I'm stuck for a very long time. No, I know. I mean, the Wind Waker stream, that's a prime example where that should not have happened. Or when my brain broke in Wario Land and I just couldn't get across this bridge. I'm only human, it happens. So why is this important? I'm trying to find the first thing I can do. Second microphone dedicated to the hairdryer. You joke about that, but that's something I could make happen. I have the mic that I used to have before this one. It's somewhere. And that one would definitely pick it up. I mean, that's the end spot, obviously, so... I remember that the first time I did this, it did take a while, so... This is the wisdom one. Achieve anything? I want to know what... Oh, there's a button there. There's a button on the other side of this.
Okay.
Just remember yeeting the ball around. I do remember throwing the ball as well. Just have no lead at the moment. Other than this, but I feel like that's the last step. Oh, I see it. Okay. There it is. It took longer than I would have liked, but what is that on the wall by the door? It looks like it's a conveyor belt thing. But no, this is step one. Whoa, motion controller. Reset. The stamina drain. Oh, just made it. In my mind, I was like, there's probably an enemy here. I mean, I'm gonna get healed at the end. Thought enemies didn't drop hearts. They do if you have the heart medallion, which I have. At the start, they do not, and that was, yeah. It was not fun. Oh, this is, I don't know, it should be straightforward, right? Just do this. Still not far away enough. It's gotta be in a specific spot. There we go. Do I have to stop this? Or does it always stop in the same spot? There, ah. What? I guess it's just a spot for that. Alright. It was just finding the first thing I needed to do, and the rest of it falls into place. Okay, now this should have done it. There we go. Strike! The Triforce is complete. With its power, you have the ability to make Zelda's wish of vanquishing Demise a reality. Hang in there. Hang in there, Joy-Con. Hang in there. Happy statue. I still think it's freaky that their mouths move. Master, I believe at this juncture, a prayer is required. The ultimate goal we have traveled so far for is now within reach. Focus now and wish with all your might for the destruction of Demise. Wish for a really big sandwich. Simpsons did it. Sorry, those that like Waddles there, but Waddles is about to eat the statue. I don't understand how you think that that thing is cute.
Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay
Think it looks like Samehada from Naruto. You know what? Yeah. I see it. Wish you lived on a small ass island in the sky. One that was self-sufficient. Master Link, I have news. I have confirmed that the Isle of the Goddess, which was formerly part of Skyloft, has returned to the surface. Furthermore, I have detected the successful eradication of demise. Your prayers to the Triforce has been heard. In light of these factors, the seal maintaining through her age-long sleep is no longer necessary. My projections indicate she will wake momentarily. Thank God for her bee's insight. I advise you to make your way to the sealed temple as soon as possible. I mean, that's not the worst fee dialogue. Hands down, the worst fee dialogue was when I was in the boat dungeon, and she was like, "Master, this door seems important. I think you need to get a key for it." Really, Fee? 6 dungeons in and you're gonna tell me that the door to the boss is important? And that it requires a key? Almost 30 hours into the game. Did you know that that island is on the ground now? Wow. Maybe Faye just thinks Link is very stupid. I don't know. Faye was right. Yeah, I mean, no one's denying that she's what she's saying isn't correct. She's definitely saying the correct thing. It just doesn't need to be said. That's the scapegoat of someone that's kind of a dick, is just being technically correct. That's their out. It's like, well, I'm correct. It's like, yes, no one is saying you're not correct, but there's a way to approach things. Chat, if you play Stardew Valley, Demetrius tells his wife that tomato is technically a fruit, and why is she angry? That when she asked for fruit, he brought tomatoes home. Demetrius is technically correct, but he's also technically a wanker. I'm just saying, Fee is approaching that territory. Good morning, Link. I do like the time gate. That looks really cool. I'm sorry. Just kidding. Lol, JK, not dead. Yeah, so look at the markings that he has, not on his face, but on his body. This is all very touching, but I'm afraid I have to cut this emotional moment short. It's best for everyone if you forget about your friend. The little goddess is mine now. It's better when he has his cape off. You can see it. You can kind of see it on his right leg as well. My master may have perished in this age, but in the past he lives yet. I'm taking the girl back through that gate to help me revive the Demon King. You've been so adorably dogged in your quest to get in my way, and as such, it has delighted me. I can no longer tolerate you nipping at my heels. You know, boy, you've really pushed me too far. The moment I sweated and bled for is at hand. I don't even have the time to grind my heel into a worm like you. Not now! I should probably go get potions. You know, this is important that we need to attend to this as soon as possible, but I did use 2 potions. Stand down.
You're in my way, and the sight of your appalling hair makes my gorge rise. Excuse me, your what? The sight of your hair makes my gorge rise. What? What? Why am I stunlocked on this sentence? I've already beaten him like 20 times. Yeah, I know. Done a fine job of spoiling my plans to revive the Demon King in this age, so I see no point in dawdling here. But in the past, oh, the past, so full of possibilities, I shall resurrect him. There with the divine soul of this golden-haired girl. But I mean, if you weren't watching, then hey, this might look a little impressive when I fight him. Okay, before we do that... Because what, I... Yeah. At this point, there's not going to be natural health regen, I believe. I don't think hearts are going to appear. Apparently, it makes my gorge rise means it makes you gag. Okay. I'm not familiar with that phrase. It just sounded like he was getting an erection from his hair. I didn't want to say it, but... My brain is in the gutter. So hold up. I think I need to replace that purple potion I have, because I think that only heals for a little bit. It's not a full heal. Yeah, and we're gonna swap these in a minute, so... It's been warning me for the last hour. I'll get to see out the potion, so hold up. Let's just see. Yeah, it only restores 8 hearts, so... Wait, you can upgrade this again? Can be used twice? Okay. I am interested, but I need more, butterflies, so... Gorge means stomach contents, and... Yeah, I guess that makes sense, yeah. Okay. And is where the term comes from, about gorging on food. That makes sense. But... I don't know, the gorge rise. I think the internet has ruined me as a person. Honestly. I mean, this is pointless, right? I'm putting it on the shield, it does nothing. Think the internet has ruined your chance at you had at normalcy, but yes. Yeah, but being normal is overrated. Being weird, at least you're interesting.
I know. Low battery.
Ooh, I don't have any volcanic ladybugs. I know where to get them. I'll swap them now. Give me a sec. You know what? So we're not standing around doing nothing. We'll do some good old-fashioned fan service, and then I'll swap my Joy-Cons. Only the little island fell, yeah. That's right, not the whole thing. Okay, now I'm gonna be careful because I don't want to pull out the sword accidentally. What did I just say? It's okay, they're safe. They're down there. Chat would never forgive me if I attacked these things accidentally. Was it me that said I really hated the Forest Temple in Ocarina of Time? Yeah, I just noticed that it looped because of the background sounds it was making. It just, yeah, I don't know. Could have been better. Okay, now there's no danger. Alright. Putting these ones to charge, and we'll see how this goes. Right, this way. I'm always afraid of putting the rails in the wrong way. I've seen what happens when you do. They get stuck, and it's scary. Okay. These should hopefully last. And if they don't, the other... What? Whoa. What do you mean one of them? That's probably an error. Okay, anyway. You'd forgive me? Okay. Well, that's good. One person would forgive me. Wait, there's usually butterflies here. Where are they? I want to upgrade the potion. Where are the butterflies? What? The butterflies are gone. Why are they gone? Let me go inside a building, unless I scared them off. What? So, I mean, No, they're here. Okay. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. I think that's enough to upgrade the final potion. I only needed a couple more. Oh, wait, no, but I needed ladybugs as well. Yeah, these ones are gone. I don't know why. Such technique. This is what Wii games were. When it came down to it, you could take the time to do precise movements, like as if you're using an imaginary object in your hand, or you could just waggle the controller up and down and probably achieve the same result. Alright, I'm going... I know where to look for them. It's pretty easy. But I think this is important because I struggled with the final fight. In fact, I sort of had a bit of a conniption. Maybe with my extreme controllers it'll be better, but having to flick that analog stick precisely, very quickly, it was tricky. Oh, no, no, tilt! Crap. Whoops. And this is where our story ends, for Link, instead of going to save the princess, decided to go hunt for some ladybugs and plummeted to his death because he miscalculated. It's okay. No health was lost. I don't know how I managed to do that. This is where we're going. I'm gonna need a few auto-imagined, so... This is the room. And it's nice and easy. Well, so I thought. Where are they? Okay, so it's a random number. Anywhere between 0 and 3. At least this is nice and quick. It's just rah, 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 rah. All right, we can go now. That should be enough, hopefully. If I have enough to make the potion that can be used twice for just two of them, that's enough. It's surely 6 full heals and I can get this fight. And if I don't, I'll just load from the save point. It's fine. You know what? We might be able to start a Link Between Worlds tonight. Because it's only 11. Barely 11. And this is the end. Not gonna lie, I love that game. I thought Boss Rush was gonna take me a few hours, but I did it in a pretty decent time. You love A Link Between Worlds? So do I. It's one of my favorite 2D ones outside of A Link to the Past and Oracle of Seasons and Ages. I do have love for Zelda 2 as well, but that's... Oh, they're back. Weird. What's my favorite game that I've done so far? I mean, my favorites are always my favorites. It's like, I love A Link to the Past. I love Twilight Princess. Out of the new... If you were to say out of the ones that I played that I hadn't played before, so... Wind Waker, Majora's, this one, technically. I really enjoyed Majora's. The OG is my least favorite. No. The OG I'd love, but it's not... It's somewhere in the middle, the OG one. That one is... It's a childhood memory, but... I know its flaws. My least favorite... is now Spirit Tracks. I was about to say Phantom Hourglass, but no, Spirit Tracks. after all that stuff that happened with the hairdryer, yeah. And just the final fight where I spent 20 minutes with a hairdryer in my hand. Do you know how stupid I looked? Like... I was just getting more and more annoyed. It looks like I'll be able to... If I get more of these butterflies, we can do it. Which is fine, they're just outside. Forgot about Spirit Tracks, yeah. Yeah. Alright. Talking about before it, I guess, I'm trying to think which Zelda game I found the weakest. It's a hard question. I guess... Probably Zelda 1. But that's... It's not because it was a bad... game, it's just when you put them side by side against all the other ones, like, I could acknowledge it's not the best game, it has its problems, and it's just because it's the first one in the series, and it was an NES game, so NES games always had that reputation. What? Hints? What do you mean, hints? You need hints to finish the game? Because all the other ones I played, I did enjoy. It's just, I guess maybe my memories of Spirit Tracks weren't as strong, so I must have masked out the fact that I did not like the microphone stuff. Or maybe the microphone stuff was just fine on the original DS. And that's probably why I didn't think about it being tedious. A Link to the Past was what started Zelda's legacy. Oh no, that's where they got it right. That started the modern Zelda formula. It was effectively what they probably wanted the original to be without the free exploration. Zelda 2... The fan remake is the way to play that game now. And... I think that game had a lot of good ideas, and I enjoy it more than the original. And I know that might be a slightly unpopular opinion, because I know people that hate that game. It was kind of wild to see with the, because they had that big leak, where they got a bunch of Nintendo games in early development, and... for Ocarina of Time, was it Ocarina of Time or Majora's Mask? But one of those two games, the earliest builds of it, they had some powers from Zelda 2 in there, like Link could turn into a fairy. which was crazy to see. It was ultimately never put in the game, but it was a nod to Zelda 2, so they thought about a mechanic like that at some point. And it's rare that they do that. once I just have to upgrade the potions and then we'll move on to the finale. I have no idea how much Demise is gonna hit for in hero mode. That's why I'm worried. It's gonna be something like 6 hearts. I mean, if he hits for 3, originally, he's gonna hit for 6. Are those potions vegan? No, because... Look. Look at what's happening. Hey, chat. Wait, what am I missing from it? Sorry, I missed it. I thought I had the ingredients. Butterflies? Elden Roller and a butterfly. Dung beetle, alright. That's fine. Okay, yeah. Hey, chat. Why do vegans prefer to ride bicycles? Because they want to get from A to B, but don't avocado. Why doesn't that only apply to vegans? Because they love avocados. That's the boomer joke. It's a boomer joke. Kids these days, you know, they'd be able to afford a house if they stopped spending money on avocados, you know? They'd be able to afford that box in the city. Cost them $500,000 for a cardboard box. They'd be able to afford that if they stopped having avocados in the morning. It's topical. Topical joke. Oh yeah, I disabled the follow age thing. But if you want to know... What does it say? Wait, they got rid of it too here? You should be able to click your own name. And then it says when you've been following since. There is no follow age here anymore. You unfollowed, yes, accidentally. But you did that in the past as well. It's the second time you've done it. Well, rip follow streak. It's like, I mean, it's okay. If you didn't like my joke about avocados, then I understand. So, hey, Nick. Chat, the reason I disabled it is because for a period in time, there were... I don't know what was going on, but I was just getting people... Wait. We're going to the entry. Hang on. Where were the dung beetles? No, it's ascent. I'm going to the ascent. There were certain people... that would come into the stream, they were top follow age. And, you know, it would be like, oh, they followed a year ago. And then that would be it. They wouldn't say hi or anything. And even weirder still, they'd come back like a few months later and do it again. I don't know if it was a bot or something, but I was like, ugh. I mean, if you want to know, Twitch gives you a way of doing it, so. Hope everyone is doing well. I'm doing well. I have my week off work, so. Just about to finish this game. Alright, that's all I need. I don't need any more. Thought I stopped streaming, but it was you that unfollowed. Well, you're not the first to say that, because I believe Cookie had a similar issue. I've had at least 5 people who swear that they didn't unfollow, and I believe them. I mean, maybe it's a mistap. If you have the mobile app, maybe that might be a reason why it happened. Because I've heard janky things happening with the mobile app. You got 10 days off after this week. Damn, nice. I now have 2 vegan jokes. The avocado one I do like. Because it's wordplay. Alright, let's get this potion and then we march to the end. Full heals. If I can't do this, I'll be shocked. Can you just say you love my accent? I said mobile, so different than what you're used to hearing. Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. You can say it. It's honestly, it's something I've heard quite a bit. As a kid, I got the opposite. People did not like the way I sounded, because I guess I spoke too quickly. And it wasn't nasally like this, you know, typical Aussie, right? But, I guess when they became somewhat of an adult, that opinion changed. You got bullied for speaking posh? I'm sorry, that happened. Yeah, I got made fun of for not sounding Aussie enough. But then, as, I don't know, maybe from the age of 16 onwards, it was like, oh, I like how your voice sounds, and I just would never believe it. It took the longest amount of time for me to accept that compliment. Can I say... You want me to say shrimp on the barbie? Oh, yeah! Yeah, now put a shrimp on the barbie! Satisfied? I would have said the C word, but you know, YouTube doesn't like the C word. You don't, you just have more of a neutral accent since you moved around a bit. Ah! Yeah, that makes sense. Because the UK goes pretty wild with its accent variation. Okay. Here we go. You've always been glad you don't have a southern accent, that you're from the south. Right, like, southern states of America, not South America. Whenever I try to do an American accent, it always comes out south. It doesn't sound right. I don't know why I can't do it. Oh wait, I have to talk to her, because she just looked like she was chilling, but she's actually hurt. Ugh, Link. It's Garahim. He appeared out of thin air and got the drop on me. Don't worry about me. You must chase after him. He ran through the great doors at the front of the temple. You may yet catch him before it's too late. Hurry. And as far as British accents go, like, I can't really do them beyond, for some reason, I don't know how I got into this, but just... As a kid, I liked, my parents used to listen to the Beatles, and so I liked their music. And there was that, Yellow Submarine thing. And I just used to I don't even know which one I'm imitating, but the trigger word is like, oh, you know, we're in a band, and that's my British accent, just continuing that. Can I say mobile with an American accent? Oh, shit. Hold on. I'm gonna mute and try and get into the American accent. Can't do it. It just doesn't sound right. I can't do it. It's just gonna sound stupid. Wait, the door's in front of the temple. This is behind me. Mobile. Oh, alright. See, that sounds southern, but, like, it sucks. Alright, well, we're going outside. See? It's not American. I can't do it properly. Sword. Skyward sword. Alright. Try do the Aghanim. Oh, I said Aghanim. It's Garahim. Fight. Using I don't even know the difference between a Midwestern accent, so I don't know. I'm not sure I'm doing a good job right now, but yeah. I don't know. It sounds shit, doesn't it? You can be honest. That's for April Fools. I got a southern accent. Yeah, I know, and I don't want it to be, because that's just lazy. For April Fools, I was going to stream the entirety of it with an American accent, but I listened to myself and I was like, no, it's not gonna work. So instead, I did the warrior voice for 2.5 hours. It was better. Hear me, my hordes. The spell is nearly complete. The Demon King returns. Until then, you'll keep that whelp from interfering with my ritual. I don't care if the whole lot of you get lodged on the end of this blade. You will buy me the time I need. Okay. Sure, auto-progress the text. Mobile? Mobile? I don't know. I mean, I know error is error. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. I'm dwelling on it now. Yeah, a little. What about well, okay, I'll say aluminium, but I know you say aluminum. I have cousins in LA, so I know how they talk. How do we get aluminium? How the fuck do you guys get bologna from Bologna? I think, you know, there's many questions to be asked about how you get to certain pronunciations. Why is chicken put between two pieces of bread? Always a chicken sandwich, regardless of what it is. Whereas in with beef, you actively say like patty melt. Chat, if you ask for a chicken sandwich here in Australia, and I'm sure other places in the world, you get a piece of chicken between two pieces of sandwich bread. If you say chicken burger, it's a piece of chicken between a burger bun. You would call it a burger, but okay. What would you call... Patty melt is apparently a regional thing, from what I've heard. But the logic here is... This is a conversation you never have to have in Australia. You go order a chicken sandwich, you do not ask what bread it comes with. Like, let's say you absolutely hate sandwich white bread. Are you really going to ask, what bread does that come with? No. Here, it's completely clarified in the name. It's chicken sandwich, it's sandwich bread. Chicken burger is the buns that you would see in a burger. No clarification required. I guess, like, follow the logic is... A burger. Would you call it a burger if it was in a hot dog roll, for example? Hot dog bun, I should say, sorry. Just to be clear. Would you call it a chicken sandwich if it was in a hot dog bun? If you were to put a beef patty in a hot dog bun, what would you call it? Would you still call it a burger? Hot dogs aren't sandwiches. Oh no. I mean, if we're gonna start debates, chat, how many holes does a donut have? One, okay. What about a toilet roll? Like, you know, toilet paper roll. Or let's say a straw. How many holes does a straw have? Depends how many holes are in the straw. Well, just a straw. Two ends. How many holes does a tunnel have?
If you were to get a donut that was as long as a straw, how many holes would it have? Would it still have one hole, or is it because it's longer that it gains a second hole? Or did it already have two holes to begin with? Why does a tunnel count as one hole or two holes, depending on your perspective? What about a donut, right? Let's say you get a solid donut. One that doesn't have a hole in it, and you punch a hole in it. That means it has one hole, but what if you get a donut that's shaped like a ring? And then you put the two ends together. Does that still make a hole? I'm just trying to bring an existential crisis here. I've lost a lot of health. I probably should have been focusing on what I was doing. Oh no. Yeah, I'm gonna redo this. The hole denotes a lack of matter in an otherwise congruous plane. If you take a piece of paper with a hole punched in it, it's one hole. There's a lot of answers to this. Where's my chair of healing? There's my chair of healing. Okay, what about this? Say you start with a log and you drill a hole in either end, it doesn't meet. So the holes don't meet. You would say you have two holes. But then you make them meet. Is it still two holes or is it one hole? You would still say you drilled two holes, but then it becomes one hole. I should stop. Why am I getting so disoriented with this room? You want a donut? Yeah, me too. I don't have sweet stuff that often, but when I'm in a mood, it's definitely the right thing to go with coffee. Donut we all. Sorry. Just appropriate reaction to that joke. Do we have good donuts here? Yes, we do. Australia, particularly Melbourne and Sydney, they are a melting pot when it comes to food. You can think of any country and you can get food for it, or a fusion of it. Because here, we don't do chain coffee that often, like we're coffee snobs. Starbucks failed here in Australia.
because we just did not consider it coffee. So they had several hundreds of stores, and it's pretty much down to single digits across certain states. And the only reason they have them is just now they're pretty much there for Americans visiting. They're trying to be a familiar face while you're overseas. But yeah, you go to any local coffee shop and they'll have some amazing donuts. Or there's bakeries you can go to as well. Which, if you go there, definitely gotta try the meat pies. Tim Hortons is pretty decent. I've heard. I'm not saying coffee chains can't be decent, but I think here it's just, I don't know, the culture is just... We appreciate quality coffee. And it's also a social thing, like, you know, you tend to have, well, at least in the sense of an office, like, you kind of know your local coffee shop. And, I don't know, when something's too corporate, it's less of that vibe because people don't give a shit. And rightfully so. You're afraid to go to Australia, we have snakes and giant spiders. Yeah, but America has guns, and you're more likely to get destroyed by a gun than getting destroyed by a wild animal in Australia. Like, I've been here for a very long time, my entire life, practically. And in that time, I've only come across an animal that I was like, oh shit, that's going to kill me, once. And that was because I was in the middle of nowhere. That's the only time it happens. If you visit places like Melbourne, Sydney, or you're staying in the cities, it's unlikely you're gonna come across that stuff. It's only really when you go up north, which is Australia's equivalent of, you know, the deep south. It's the people, not the gun. No, I know. I'm not saying the guns will literally kill you. I'm just saying the odds of something happening that's gun related. I'd be more afraid of that. I think they released a number as well that said, like, you're more likely to get struck by lightning than getting attacked by a shark. It just doesn't happen. Again, only if you stick to common areas. All right. Sit down. I think I just need to suck it up and heal. I don't think I'm gonna get through this. I mean, I don't want to go too deep into, like, you know, that topic, because it is a touchy thing, but all I'll say on it is, like, in Australia we used to have them, and now you need special requirements to get one. And we just don't have to worry about that stuff happening in the general public. And that's a good thing. Yeah, we don't have to have the conversation. We're not going to. I'd rather talk about, oh, shit. Okay. It's a good thing I saved. There we go. Which file? I guess this one, because it's just... I don't trust the autosave. Okay. Just go through this again. Anyway, the point I was trying to get across, don't be afraid to visit Australia. The whole animals and wildlife and all that crap attacking you is a bit of a meme. And, if there's one thing that Australians like to do, it's just, lie to tourists to scare them a little. I mean, there's so many different ones. There's the drop bear. There's the bunyip. What else? I think those are the biggest two that they'll use to scare tourists. What's my favorite Australian snack they don't you don't have in the US? Well, one you can make, or one that you can just buy. Because there's one snack that I think isn't talked about much, but it's like a staple for kids in Australia when they have a birthday in school. In terms of stuff you can buy, I mean, Tim Tams is like the most known one, and doing that Tim Tam slam thing, it's definitely something worth experiencing. But also from what I've heard, like, our Milo is something that people look after. Apparently the formula for our Milo is different to other countries. It's more or less like the original one. Alright, so follow me on this one. This is pretty easy to make. All you're gonna need, white bread. You're going to need a form of vegetable shortening. I mean, the term is margarine, but you know, find something similar to that. I don't know what you have access to. And then get rainbow sprinkles. This is the important thing. They have to be rainbow, not butter. It can't be butter. It has to be margarine. It has to be something that comes in a tub and is spreadable. And it's minimal effort to spread it. The rainbow sprinkles, highest importance. Now, what you're going to do, you're going to get a slice of white bread. The thicker the better. You're going to get the margarine, you're going to spread it like you would peanut butter. So pretty liberally done, right? Don't be shy. And then you're going to sprinkle as much sprinkles as you can on top of that bread. And then you're going to cut it into a triangle. And then you're going to consume that. Now, if you can't get your head around the vegetable shortening being used like peanut butter and being very thick, rest assured, what happens is, because of the sprinkles, it kind of tastes like icing. And so you kind of end up with like this budget cake. And it is delicious. And that's what happens for birthday parties when you're in school. They'll go out, they'll buy some white bread, sprinkles, margarine, and then kids will make it and they'll eat it. And it's good. It's called fairy bread. It's very fun if you have kids. Because it's easy for them to make. It doesn't make too much of a mess. and it tastes good. Have I had a PB&J? No, because we don't really have... I thought there was a difference between... There wasn't a difference between jelly and preserves. But apparently there is, so we don't really have anything that is like jelly here. Like, our stuff is jams and preserves. But that's, yeah, that's purely an American thing. No jelly. I mean, we may... I don't know. I'd have to look. But the thing they sell mainly is fruit preserves, which I believe is not quite jelly. Preserves are different. Yeah, so that's what we primarily have. It's the same with candy cereals. We don't really have too many of those here. Do I really... Can I just run past all this, honestly? Is this a bad idea? Is this a bad idea? Uh-oh. Oh, what now? It's the bombs that makes this... They're draining my health, and I need health by the time I get down there. Okay, hold up. There's a heart here. Hey. If you want a good Australian beverage to try, there's a company called Bundaberg that do an excellent ginger beer. A very good ginger beer. And I believe you can find it in America. I think they sell it on Amazon even. I've had some chat members try it and they love it. Bunda. BUNDABERG. It's a yellow bottle and it has a polar bear on it. They make rum primarily, but they also make really good soft drinks. They have a lot of different flavors. But their ginger beer is probably the most popular one. Okay. What now? I can see the downside to running because I'm gonna get this and then I have to deal with everything. I'm just gonna have to heal. I got no choice. Where is that one with the horn? That's the one causing all the problems. That one, that one. Come here. I have to take it out. Where is it? 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 Oh, that... This is obnoxious. Alright, drop. Ah, What? It ran into an area I can't get to. Is this just scripted that I can't get rid of this dick? This just sucks. Dude. I can't even take a minute to... Okay, let's try and claw shot. Got it. Yeah, I'm kind of in a bad spot here. No, I have potions. I don't want to use them until the end. I do have them. It's just, this is a point of no return, right? Like, I can't keep crafting after this. Okay, now I'll use one. You can get more before demise. Yeah, but I'd have to go get more bugs. Oh, come on. Right, now I absolutely have to. Hey, that's fine. Okay, don't ever do it. All right. Jeez. You're far too quick, boy. I can do it. I realize a simple child like you knows nothing of magic, but spells like this take time and a steady hand. Can't you wait quietly like a good boy? You know what? Fine. If you're so intent on hurrying to your grave, I'll be happy to show you your way. This time there will be no heroic escape. I was a fool to toy with you and let you walk away with your life before, but I won't make that mistake again. This just reminds me of Dragon Ball. Yeah, let the bad guy power up. No problem. Did I use that video you sent? I did not. I did watch it. But I figured something out for myself. If only I'd put you in your place from the very beginning. Show human little mercy and the next thing you know, he thinks himself your equal. Given my situation, I had to maintain some semblance of dignity, so... I'll let you run with your life, twice even. Such a guilty pleasure. But instead of scurrying away like any creature with a basic instinct to survive, you just kept coming back again and again and again! I've let a mere boy make a fool of me for the last time. You stand before a demon, or should you say, a weapon without mercy. For you, boy, I prepared a most appropriate and humiliating death. I even name a pet for it. I call it the Endless Plunge. I'll delight in casting your body into this pit and snuffing out the flame of your life. Your broken body will serve as a fine sustenance for the Demon King. Okay. All right. I mean, this is kind of sad. Hey! There we go. Okay.
This fight has lost a little bit of its impact. Got it! Jab. That's the one that always gets me. It's okay. I only have this fight to worry about. So prepare me for Breath of the Wild and all the fun I'm gonna go through with this one. Oh crap. I wasn't aware it was charging. The three heart mode thing is gonna be fun! Ah. It's no stress.
You wretched brat!
It's okay. Wow, streamer, how are you so good at this? I don't know, first try, what can I say? That being said, when I did succeed getting the shield, I beat this Girahim and the other Girahim hitless. I did the first 5 fights without taking a hit, so you know. I have my skill when it shines through at last. This is preposterous. Driven to my knees by a simple child of man. Laughable. No matter how many times we clash, I can't prevail. You think I can't defeat you? You think I can't win? Boy, what are you? but never mind. That victory is still mine to savor. While we fought, the ritual I started continued. At last, it's complete. The Demon King shall devour the soul of the goddess and resurrect in his full glory. The rush is so much harder because of hero mode, just taking damage is not good. Wait, I have to do this again? I thought Waddles was dead. You want to hug that?
Samehara, okay.
Don't you see? It's all over. You and your kind have lost this world and everything in it is now in the dark.
I get lazier when it comes to reading. This just looks like a Street Fighter character. There you go, there's Waddles. Samehara, whatever, there's your cute creature. Welcome back to us, Master. Sword also has a Triforce in it. I don't know, this seems like a point of no return.
So you are the chosen knight of the goddess. Intriguing. The goddess lowered herself to a mortal existence to keep me imprisoned. How pathetic. This bag of flesh pales in comparison to the magnificence of her previous form.
Don't worry, Link. Grace has got this. Link, I caught her. She's okay.
So you and that other human would stand before obliteration to the goddess, would you? How curious. The humans I've known were weak things, hardly more than insects, shivering under rocks, and ready to flee at the mere glimpse of me. When last I walked this world, I did little more than scream and cling to their goddess, mewling and praying. Counting on her to protect them. How amusing those cowards begot someone like you.
Failed to save Zelda again.
You grow more fascinating by the second, human. I never imagined to meet one of your kind who wished to stand against me in battle. Very well then, I shall prepare a place for us. We will not be bothered by distractions. If you still have the courage to face me, seek me there.
Okay, so I can go somewhere.
Link, it's all on you. Listen up. Granny had some info for you. The old girl says it'll take time for that grease ward to absorb Zelda's soul completely. If you can take him down before her soul gets all sucked up into that thing, you might still have a chance. I know you can do it. So yeah, you gotta do this. You're all Zelda's got. You've got to make this happen.
Fear for your life. Do not follow me. You can spend what little time your world has left cowering and crying, as befits your kind. But if you truly desire to raise your blade against the world I would build, come for me. I've waited eons to return. I can spare a few moments to let you decide.
It's up to you now, Link. Okay. Well, I mean... Oh. I have to buy another potion and craft it. Because it counts as a use. I mean... Should I, or should I just say screw it and just go in? I mean, you would think 5 heals would be enough. You would think. I guess if it's not enough, I can do it afterwards and just load the file and go get the extra heal. This fight is pretty hard. Oh, I know. I don't remember it 100%, but I know. The problem is I don't quite 100% remember. I know the Skyward Strike is involved. But I guess I'll see how I go. Dang, dang, dang. Alright. Ugh. Man. Parkour! Alright, sit in the chair. We are at the end. I'll save outside down there. I'm just happy that I got to 100% this game. I didn't get to do it last time. Wait. Isn't there a save point out here? Oh no, it's over there. So this is just straight up a sword fight. It just doesn't matter. I'm not sure how this is gonna go. I'm worried about how much damage he's gonna do. Oh, Fee, come on. There is a 0% chance you'll be able to return. Well, at least that's the only certain thing she's said. That's the only thing she's said with certainty. The most negative thing. Okay, wish me luck. It's been 2 years since I was here. I did think this looked cool though, just visually. For an evil person, sure made quite the beautiful sight, you know, to act as a backdrop for this fight.
Ah, so you've decided to meet your end in battle after all. It pleases me greatly. See such misplaced valor, human. Take a moment to appreciate your surroundings, for where we stand shall serve as your tomb for eternity. the hate for the gods that has boiled in my veins. You will taste all of it. The bite of my blade. The only question left is how long will you manage to remain standing before I take your life? Try to keep it interesting for me, would you? When you do fall, know that your world and everything in it is mine to dominate, mine to subjugate, mine to rule! When I finish with you, you can take solace in knowing your friends and kin will soon follow, as I wipe all who oppose me from the face of this world! I don't know.
Oh, come on, dude. Just stop talking. It won't be long now. At last, the almighty power I've sought for millennia. I can't keep doing that voice. I will take the Triforce for my own.
And the world shall be under my foot for all eternity. Blah, blah, blah.
All right. Oh. Being patient. Honestly, if it weren't for the shield, I'd be doing so much worse. I'm kind of glad I got it. No! Fate! Shut up! Accidentally pressed the down button. Okay, hang on. I need a sec to regroup. Crap camera! That went through the shield, apparently. Ugh.
Monica. Didn't give me time to heal. Motion control screwed me. Losing track of the controller, so I can't. So, yeah, that was fine. I didn't need all those potions, I guess. Oh, yeah. Sorry, the inner Australian came out.
Extraordinary. You stand as a paragon of your kind, human. You fight like no man or demon I've ever known, though this is not the end. My hate never perishes. It is born anew in a cycle with no end. I will rise again. Those like you, those who share the blood of the goddess and the spirit of the hero, they are eternally bound to this curse. An incarnation of my hatred shall ever follow your kind, dooming them to wander a blood-soaked sea of darkness for all time.
All right. I think the reason that went so well was just because of boss rush. It put my combat skills up to the next level. God damn it, Feet! You don't need to point that out. I saw it in front of my own two eyes. Master, I have confirmed the eradication of the Demon King. His residual consciousness has been absorbed into the Master Sword and is now sealed away. Oh, man. Yes, GG. I will say that fight felt a lot better with motion controls. Now that I've played both. You've done well, Link.
Oh,
Link, thank you. I think it's over. Finally, it's all over. Nice going, you two. You guys were totally amazing in this little adventure I like to call The Legend of Groose. That's a little joke. I still think this series should have ditched the whole Legend of Zelda naming a long time ago and just should have called it The Legend of the Triforce, because then it makes more sense. I mean, originally, sure, it was about rescuing Zelda and just why, but after a certain point, it stops being that. Joke or not, your contributions to our effort were heroic. You have my thanks. The Legend of Fate? I mean, this is what this story is. Oh well, you know, just glad I could make myself useful. I'm happy things turned out okay. Oi. Hey, so things look pretty sewn up here. What do you say, guys? Ready to head back to our own time? Granny was really worried about you two. We don't want to keep the old girl in suspense too long. Hylia, your grace, or perhaps you prefer Zelda. It pleases me to know you are safe. Master, I must speak with you. Master Link, you have successfully protected the goddess reborn and defeated demise, fulfilling your role as the hero of legend. My purpose here is complete, therefore I ask you to dissolve our arrangement as master and servant. Drive the sword into the pedestal before you, and I'll return to the sword to enter a sleep without end. Master, you have achieved the purpose you were chosen to fulfill. Please set the sword in the pedestal and bring the goddess's mission to an end. Now, Master, it is time to conclude our necessary companionship. I appreciate that the Hylian shield is on his back, because the first time I finished it, it was that bootleg looking shield and it just did not look right. it looked like a knockoff game. Because it's got the shape, not really the color, and it's got a weird symbol on it, but this just feels right. Link. Link, hear me. My purpose was to obey the command of the goddess and lead you, the chosen hero of this land, on your quest. When I first awoke and began this task, I perceived it as merely serving my function as a servant to her grace. However, I have come to consider the information corresponding to our time together among the most precious data I have on record. I do not have the capability to fully understand the human spirit, Link. But now at the end of my journey with you, as I prepare to sleep within the Master Sword forever, I experience a feeling I am unable to identify. I lack sufficient data to be sure of my conclusion, but I believe this feeling correlates closest to what you people call happiness. Our partnership is at an end, and even as we speak, I feel my consciousness fading away. Before I enter the sleep that calls me to the sword, I wish to relay to you words that I recorded many times over the course of our journey. Many have said them to you thus far, but now I wish to say them for myself. Thank you, Master Link. May we meet again in another life. What? Impa, why? Come with us. Zelda, your grace, you possess the memories of the goddess. You must understand why that is not possible. I am a being of this age. My place is here. I know that, but... You must return to your own time. I will take care of the gate once you've passed through. I can't do that. You and I have been through so much together. I don't want to leave you alone. Please, Impa, come back with us. Zelda, at the command of the goddess, I passed through the gate of time. I did so to protect you and aid the fight to prevent the world's destruction. The last remnants of demise are decaying slowly within the sword. Someone must stay behind to watch over this blade. His spirit must not reawaken. He must never be allowed to threaten the world again. This is the nature of the task given to my tribe. As a member of the Sheikah, the goddess's chosen guardians, I gladly welcome this duty. Zelda, I shall watch over the Triforce. Its power is too great to leave in the grasp of man. Dependence on its might is an invitation to disaster. When it has served its purpose, it must be secreted away to lie dormant once again, the knowledge of its existence hidden from mortal history. These are the words the goddess spoke to me long ago. I remember them well, as do you, I'm sure. Do not despair, Zelda. You and I will surely meet again someday. It's always funny to see just such a futuristic looking thing, but then it's ancient. That was the purpose of the hair wheel. To hide that until now. See? I told you we'd meet again. I, for one, am shocked at that revelation. Really? Because Faye didn't point it out? Impa, thank you. Thank you for everything.
Alright. That was, Skyward Sword HD, but in hero mode this time. Now, don't go anywhere because you need to wait for the post-credit sequence where Nick Fury invites the sword to the Avenger Initiative. But, you know, we'll wait until it gets up to that point. I enjoyed this a lot more the second time around. Just, I think it was a mistake not to use motion controls from the beginning. There's something to be said about playing the game the way it was intended originally. It was cool that the option was there, and I think more than anything, it was to sell people, much like myself, who skipped this one. Because when this one released, it was at a time where I was kind of tired of Wii games because all of them involved shaking and moving the controller, and sometimes I just really, really wanted it to just be a simple button press, but when I heard this one was completely motion control, I guess I didn't want to try it. And then I moved out of home and the Wii stayed with my younger brothers, so that's why I never got to play it. But, it wasn't just me knowing more or less what to do this time around. I think it's just, it definitely played a lot better. The sword fighting sequences were a lot better. And, as frustrating as Boss Rush got, I did get into it by the end of it. Just determined to get that shield. So, I'm not done with the stream tonight. There's still time before I'm gonna say bye, but I guess we have a choice. I can start Link Between Worlds, or I can do something else, but I'm kind of leaning towards starting Link Between Worlds because I do love that game. I just worry that if I start it, I might go overboard and just play longer than I want to, but I'll think about it. Start it. Yeah, I'm leaning towards it. But before I do, I just want to say thanks for tuning in. This is aimed at people watching on YouTube later, but also you, chat, who are here. I do appreciate people hanging out and chilling and chatting. And letting me do my thing, you know, play whatever game I want and just have some good times. I always say, yeah, I don't say it enough, but I do appreciate it. So, there's now two games to go before Breath of the Wild. I'm feeling a lot better about this because I was worried that I wasn't going to get enough time. I think Link Between Worlds and Triforce Heroes, they're not that long. Because DS games were not that long in general, so as long as I can dedicate roughly a month to Breath of the Wild, I think we'll be okay. I think this is gonna line up nicely. So that's the plan now, is just get through the DS games and then we go to the big piece. Where I'm gonna repeat what I did when I played it the first time, which is, we're going to be playing Master Mode. I'm not going to be wearing any sort of armor. And I'm going to be not spending the orbs or the Korok Seeds until I have acquired them all. I'm not sure about the Korok Seeds, but definitely the shrines, you know. Just do what I did last time. Rely on crafting and skill to get through the game. Because you can do it. There's no area that I found that I couldn't get to with just three hearts and basic stamina, which is a testament to, how well that game is designed. Oh boy. But I think the fighting in this game kind of got getting me ready for it, because, fighting Lynels is pretty much like the sword fighting in this game. Oh, you can skip it! You can skip the credits.
I should try that more often. Maybe because I finished the game already, but I swear you couldn't do that last time. Anyway. Here comes Nick Fury on his loft wing. No, but, I think this was a good remaster. Where have I got Link Between Worlds? It's somewhere behind me. There it is. Okay. It's on my desk now. Look around us. As a child, I always dreamed of a world below. I wanted to see the surface with my own eyes and feel the land's warm breeze on my skin. I think I want to live here. I always want to feel the solid ground beneath my feet, see the clouds above my head, and watch over the Triforce. What about you, Link? What will you do now? The end. Okay. All right. That's it. Is it gonna? No, of course it's gonna go back to main menu. Okay. Congratulations, you have conquered hero mode. Create the save before the final battle. Yeah, do it. Oh yeah, how did I do time-wise? I was curious as to how this was going to end up. I mean, come on! The original file I did in 100%. And it took 40 hours. This file, hero mode 100%, 40 hours. That's pretty damn good. Okay. Well, I'm gonna finish this VOD here. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Thanks for sticking around. Hope you enjoyed the hero mode playthrough. And look forward to a Link Between Worlds at some point in the future. So. As for everyone watching on Twitch, gonna take a small intermission for 2 to 5 minutes. I'm gonna get more water. I'm gonna stretch, and I'm also going to set up the DS so we can start a Link Between Worlds. So get a snack or something, and I'll be back shortly. But yeah, otherwise, YouTube, thanks for watching. Consider subscribing or doing the fun algorithm stuff. All right, bye, YouTube.